ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 7th பாசுரம். கீசு கீசென்றெங்கும் மானைச்சா தன் கலந்து பேசின பேச்சரவம் கேட்டிலையோ. பேய்ப்பெண்ணே காசும் பிறப்பும் கலகலப்ப கை பேர்த்து வாசனருங்குழலாச்சியர் மத்தினால் ஓசைப்படுத்த தைரரவம் கேட்டிலையோ. நாயக பெண் பிள்ளாய் நாராயணன் மூர்த்தி கேசவனை பாடவும் நீ கேட்டே கிடத்தியோ. தேசமுடையாய் திறவேலோ ரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் அண்ட் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஆர் ப்ரொசீடிங் டு டூ த பாவை நோம்பு. அண்ட் ஃபார் திஸ் பர்பஸ் தே ஹவ் ஆல் அசெம்பிள்ட் அட் ஒன் பிளேஸ் ஃப்ரம் வேர் தே ஹாவ் டு ப்ரொசீட் டு தி பேலஸ் ஆஃப் கிருஷ்ணா டு டூ தேர் பாவை நோம்பு. ஆண்டாள் சீஸ் தட் சம் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் ஹவ் நாட் டேர்ன்ட் அப் அண்ட் இன் ஆர்டர் டு include each and every friend of hers in this divine experience, Andal proceeds to the house of each girl who has not come, wakes her up and takes her along into her group. Such is the compassion of Andal. And this description has been given in scenes 2 and 3 of Thiruppavai, the waking up of Andal's friends. So in this order, we saw that Andal woke up the first friend in the 6th pasuram, and today she is proceeding to the house of the second friend in the 7th pasuram. In the 6th pasuram, Andal told about certain indications that it is dawn and it is time for us to proceed for the Pavai Nombu. The first indication that she spoke about was the chirping of birds. Now when she's reached the house of the second friend, Andal again speaks about chirping of birds as an indication of morning. She says, "Keesu keesendrengum." My dear friend, can't you hear this noise, keech, 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 the chirping of birds? And this chirping noise is heard everywhere in Rengum. But here, Andal goes a step further and specifies as to which particular bird is making this noise. She says, keesu keesendrengum aanai chaathan kalandu. The bird named aanai chaathan is making this noise. Which is this aanai chaathan bird? Aanai chaathan is also known as Bharadwaja Pakshi in Sanskrit. Bharadwaja Pakshi is a bird which gets up in the morning and makes a very nice rhythmic sound as if it sounds like the utterance of the Vedas. And that's precisely why this bird has the name Bharadwaja. Because Bharadwaja was a great saint who was known for his commitment to Vedic reciting. He was so committed to reciting the Vedas that he used 300 years of his life just reciting Vedic hymns. So Bharadwaja Maharishi was somebody who would unfailingly recite the Vedas in the morning. So by talking about Bharadwaja Pakshi, Andal wants to secretively convey that great saints like Bharadwaja have also got up and are reciting the Vedas. So it's the right time, the morning time, in which we have to get involved in divine service and not be sleeping like this. So that is what she's trying to tell the girl inside by saying, keesu keesendrengum maanai chaathan kalandu pesina pecharavam kettilayo. She's saying that saints like Bharadwaja are describing what is being said in the Vedas also. They are discussing amongst themselves. Kalandu pesina pecharavam. This discussion is about what we should do in the morning. We should not be lethargic and whiling away time, but involve ourselves in divine service. So this preaching is also happening. Can't you hear that, my friend? Hear to these saints talking amongst each other. Kalandu pesina pecharavam kettilayo. But this girl inside does not reply at all to Andal. So Andal asks her, are you obsessed? Pei penne, she says. Pei penne refers to the one who is obsessed with something like a spirit. This girl inside seems to be obsessed with Krishna Bhakti. So much so that she's not even able to hear the call of other Krishna Bhaktas. So much is her involvement in her own contemplation of Krishna that she's not able to hear about any other person speak about the same Lord Krishna also. Now that is not right. Such obsession is not good for you. So you need to come out. Please don't be obsessed. Peipenne, please come out, she's saying. But this girl is still not replying. So Andal proceeds to tell her another indication of mourning. She says, can't you hear another very nice jingling sound? What sound is that? This is the sound of the Gopikas trying to churn butter from curd. When you churn curd nicely, you get out butter. So the Gopikas do this right in the morning so that the temperature is perfect for the butter to come out. If the sun rises and they start this churning, then their butter would start becoming sour. They do not want that. So this butter churning procedure is always done in the mornings. And apparently, that sound of butter churning is being heard. Can't you hear that? She's asking. Kasum pirappum kalakalappakai perthu vasanarunkulalachiyar mattinal osaippadutha thairaravam kettilayo. She's saying that, can't you hear the noise of curd being churned? Thairaravam. And this noise, thairaravam, is mixed with the rhythm of another noise or another beautiful sound. What sound is that? Kasum pirappum kalakalappakai perthu. This jingling sound, kalakalakala, is being heard because as these Gopikas are churning, the jewels they are wearing are rubbing against each other and making a very sweet jingling sound. What kind of jewels are rubbing against each other? Andal goes ahead to describe that also. She's saying, Kasum Pirappum. It seems that these Gopika ladies are wearing two kinds of Mangala Sutras. That is, auspicious chains, which is a mark of their being auspicious. So, this Kasu refers to the ornament that a lady receives from her in-law's place, and Pirappu refers to the ornament that the lady receives from her parents' place. So, a Mangala Sutra is given from the parents' side, and another Mangala Sutra is given from the in-law's side, and a lady is supposed to wear both of them as a mark of auspiciousness. And all these Gopikas are wearing them all the time. And these ornaments are rubbing against each other to produce that sweet jingling sound. As we had said earlier, ThiruppAvai is known as Mangala Prabandham, the work of auspiciousness. So Andal every now and then ensures that she's talking about something auspicious. So here she spoke about these ladies and the nice ornaments that they are wearing as a mark of auspiciousness. Not only this, the churning of butter itself is considered as a very auspicious omen. So thus, she's talking about another Mangala aspect here. So she's saying, can't you hear these Gopikas making this sweet sound? You need to get up and come now. The girl inside lazily is now trying to reply to Andal and tell her that, why don't you people proceed? You're saying that it is dawned and you need to go and all, and that I am obsessed. So let me be with my obsession. Why do you want to take me along with you? So saying very lethargically, she's still lying down. So Andal says, my dear friend, we only said that you're obsessed with Krishna, but your obsession is going in the wrong direction. Your object of obsession is perfectly fine. And we can never do away without you because you are like our leader, Nayaga Penpillai, she calls out. You're so good in your leadership qualities that you can actually lead us to Krishna. Why don't you come and join us? You're our leader, Nayaka Penpillai. And don't you think that we really need to go to this Lord? Because who is this Lord? This Lord is Narayanan Murti. Lord Krishna is Narayana himself, who has come down for our sake as Keshava. Now, Andal has a very beautiful message in this phrase, Narayanan Murti Keshavan. Let's try to understand what it is. Andal says that we have to go to the Lord Narayana. The word Narayana has immense number of meanings. Innumerable number of meanings. One main meaning is that the letter Ram denotes something which is perishable. Naram is non-perishable. And Naram is the collection of non-perishables. So, who is Narayana? Narayana is either Naranam Ayanam, that is the place where these Naras reside, or Naraha Ayanam Yasya Saha, meaning the one who is having these Naras as his residence. Let us try to understand this a little more simply. What we are trying to say is, this Lord Narayana has all the non-perishable items within him. That is one meaning of Narayana. That is Naranam Ayanam. He has everything within him. So Narayana contains the universe within himself. The universe is something which will not stop existing. It can only change in form, but it does not perish. So it is a collection of non-perishables. So Narayana has the universe within him. This is the meaning of Naranam Ayanam. Another meaning of Narayana is the one who resides within these collection of non-perishables. Means Narayana resides everywhere in the universe. He is there in every aspect, starting from an atom till the biggest possible entity in this universe. Everything is occupied by Narayana, and that is conveyed by Naraha Ayanam Yasya Saha. So thus, this Narayana, who is all pervading, has come down for our sake, taking a form or Rupa or Murti. So this Narayanan has now become a Murti called Keshava. Who is this Keshava? Keshava is the one who slew the Asura called Keshi. And who slew the Asura called Keshi? Lord Krishna. So Narayana has come down for our sake as Krishna. And please understand that the Lord Krishna whom we are seeing in front of our eyes today is not any ordinary being. He is Narayana. He is the one who is present everywhere, and he is the one who has everything within himself. So the omnipresent Narayana, the greatest one, has chosen to come down and show us that he is attainable by us. He has come down to our clan as our Krishna for our sake. So please understand this and come out of your slumber. We need to really go to him. You have to lead us to him, because he has come down so much for us that we really need to go to him under your leadership. You cannot be sleeping like this after we are talking so much. Nee kete kidattiyo. How can you be sleeping when we are all speaking so much about that Lord Narayana who has come down as a Murti of Keshava Krishna for our sake? Please get up. You are the radiance of our group. தேசமுடையாய், ஷீஸ் காலிங் தேசமுடையாய் ரெஃபர்ஸ் டு த ரேடியன்ட் ஒன். ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் கம் அவுட் ஓ ரேடியன்ட் கோபிகா அண்ட் ஜாயின் அஸ் திரவே லோ ரெம்பாவாய். ஓபன் த டோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் யுவர் ஹவுஸ் அண்ட் ஓபன் த டோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் யுவர் ஹார்ட் அண்ட் கம் அவுட் ஆஃப் யுவர் அப்சஷன், லீட் அஸ் டு லார்ட் கிருஷ்ணா, கால்ஸ் அவுட் ஆண்டாள். அண்ட் ஆஃப்டர் சோ மச் கோக்ஸிங், வை வுட் த கோபிகா நாட் கம் அவுட்? So she came out and joined this band of Andal and her friends.